वेलकम टू माय चैनल प्यारेस प्रोग्रामिंग। आज का टॉपिक क्या है बच्चों? आज का टॉपिक है क्लास प्रोग्राम। उसमें हम क्या सीखेंगे? वी लर्न हाउ टू डिफाइन ए क्लास एंड दिस क्लास स्पेशली डिजाइंड फॉर एम्प्लॉय क्लास। वी लर्न व्हाट इज इंस्टेंस वेरिएबल, व्हाट इज मेंबर मेथड, हाउ टू डिफाइन इंस्टेंस वेरिएबल, हाउ टू आइडेंटिफाई द इंस्टेंस वेरिएबल फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन, how to define the method, how to write the main method, to call the methods. So let's start. Let's see what the question is asking for. It says that define a class employee. I have already underlined the required part. That means the class name must be employee as it is given in the question. What I need to do in this class? I need to store. What I need to store? The following information. What are the following information? I want to store employee code, employee name and basic salary. What next? It says that method. What is the method name? Get data. But here every alphabet is given in a lowercase. But as per the convention of the method, we have to write the first word lowercase and next each word first letter capital. Even though in a question it has been given, all are in lower. I will tell you how to write this while writing the program. What is the job of this method? The job of this method to accept. What to accept? Employee information. So what are the employee information that I need to accept? That we'll discuss while writing the program. Let's see what is the next part of this question. It says that define a method. One more method is available. Its name is calculate salary. Now, what I need to calculate? I need to calculate HRA, CCA, DA, PF. Now, how to calculate? It says that 42%. So which one is 42%? HRA is your 42%. Then 63 is 75 and 12 of which one? Of basic salary. Now, what next? Calculate the gross and the net salary also. Now, look at this. In the previous slide, we have seen it is talking about the instance variable is your employee code, employee name and basic salary. But if I need to calculate HRA, CCA, DA, PF, gross and net salary, where I will store? I will store it in a variable. That means these are also your instance variables. How to calculate? We'll see. Don't worry. We'll see while writing the program. What next it is saying? Calculate the tax. How to calculate? Based on the following information. What is the following information? Based on your gross salary, we need to calculate the tax. What is the next part of this question? Define one more method. Its name is print slip. What to do to display the salary information? That means I have to display the complete salary information such as basic, HRA, CCA, DA, gross, net, tax, everything. But whose salary is it? So that's why I have to display the employee code, employee name and basic salary. So I will suggest all the students, even if in the question it is talking about display salary information, for getting good marks, we have to write the display statement with complete information. What is the next part? Define a main method. What the main method will do? We'll call the above methods. What are the methods that I need to call? The accept method and calculate method and this display method. These three methods needs to be called. How to write the program? Chalo fir program likhna shuru kare. In order to write this kind of program, my first job is to define a class. So I need the class name. So let's check from the slide what is the class name. Here it is given that employee is the class name. So how to define it? I will say public, which is my access specifier. Class is the keyword. And what is the class name? Employee. After that, I will give the opening and closing curly bracket, which indicates the body of the class. This is your header of the class. This is body of the class. All the information regarding the class, I will write inside this class body. What is the next part? Instance variable. So let's check. What is the instance variable? It says that employee code, name and basic salary. So no data type is given. I have to decide. I am taking the employee code of string, EMP CODE. Why I'm taking string? Let me explain. Now, suppose an organization is maintaining an employee code called 784598. So obviously it is an integer. Then why I'm taking it in a string? Now, suppose an organization maintaining the employee code based on the department. If the employees belongs to HR department, the code is like this, H and 784598. If the employee belongs to account department, is maintaining the employee code like this. Now, in that case, how I am going to store? This is not possible to store. So that's why if I will take string, I can store both integer as well as string. So that's why I'm taking it as a string. Next is your name. So I'm saying EMP name. What next? Basic salary. Basic salary is your double. So I will say double basic. What are the other instance variables that I need to take? Let's check from the question itself. As it is calculating HRA, CCA, DA, PF. So that means I must need to declare these variables as well as gross and net salary. It is given in a capital letter, but while writing the program, I should declare it in a lowercase. So with the same data type, I'm saying HRA, CCA, DA, PF, gross and net salary. Anything else? Let's check. It is also calculating the tax. That means I need one more variable called tax. Let's check. Do I need any other variable? No, because it is saying display information and main method. So that means all the instance variable declaration is over. My suggestion is that don't declare the instance variable by looking at the initial part of the question. Read the complete question, find out all the instance variable, declare it, then move for the next part. So let's check again the question, what it is saying. After declaring the instance variable, define a method getData. Method name is your getData. And what is the operation? Accept. What is the header of a method? Return type is void. Then method name, it says that getData. But here I am using first word lowercase, next word first letter capital, getData, with no parameter. And this is the body of the method, inside which I will write the accept operation. How to do accept operation? I will declare the scanner class object. Scanner ss is equal to new scanner, within which I will write system.in. After that, I will give a message. I will say system.out.print. What is the message? Enter employee code and a delimiter. But have you marked it is showing an error message? Who can tell me why it is showing an error message? Because the scanner class is available in UTIL package, but I have not imported. So I will say import java.util.star. Now there is no error. Now after displaying the message, I will accept the data. Which instance variable I have taken over here to store employee code? EMP code I have taken. So that's why I will say EMP code is equal to scanner object is your ss.next. Sir, why not next line? Because employee code is always single word. Next message is your enter employee name. So here the instance variable, can you identify? We have taken employee name. Now employee name can contain more than one word. That's why I will say next line, which will accept more than one word, including space. After that, what more I need to accept? I need to accept basic salary. So I will say employee basic salary. Now, what is the instance variable that we have taken? Basic. What is the method? Next double. Why next double? Because the data type of the basic is double data type. That's why I will use next double. Now, accept operation is over, because rest of the instance variable will store the calculate value. The next part of the question says that define a method calculate salary. Define the method void calculate salary S capital. Now let's check in the question. What I need to calculate says that HRA is your 42% of basic. So we'll write HRA is equal to basic. So 42% kaise calculate kare? Basic into 42 divided by 100. When I'm saying 42 by 100, integer divided by integer, result is integer. So that's why what I need to do, I have to convert it into 42.0. Aur sabse achhi baat, I'm always suggesting to the student that when I'm writing 42 divided by 100, after how many zeros I need to put decimal places? After 2. So why don't you convert it like this with the fraction? That is your 0.42. Let's check what it is asking for. CCA is your 63%. What is the instance variable? CCA, you can get it from here. It is already highlighted over here. CCA is equal to basic. How much percentage of basic? 63%. So 0.63. Next, check it out. What it is saying? DA is your 75%. So what is the instance variable? DA 0.75. What is the next part? PF is 12%. So instance variable is PF 12%. Now everything we have calculated. What next? Calculate the gross and net salary. How to calculate the gross salary? Gross is equal to basic salary plus allowances. What are the allowances? HRA, house rent allowance, CCA, city compensatory allowance, DA, dearness allowance. What is PF? Provident fund, which is deducted. What is tax? It is given to the government. That means it is also deducted. So that's why I will say basic plus HRA plus CCA plus DA only. These are the allowances. So basic plus allowances is equals to your gross salary. After getting the gross salary, it is talking about to calculate net. Now how to calculate net salary? Gross minus deduction. But we have calculated only provident fund as the deduction. But one more part is also required. What is that? That is your tax. Now we have to check the tax based on this information. Different percentages of taxes are how to calculate tax. If my gross salary greater than equals to 80,000, it is asking that tax is 35%. Tax is equal to 35% of what? Of basic. So I will say basic into 0.35. Here I am not putting any comma, but you might have seen that in question comma is given because constant must not be separated by comma. So that's why I am not putting comma while writing the program. Isliye bahut kuch cheez question mein aisa hoga jisko aapko avoid karna hai while writing the program. So next range is 60 to 79,999. So I will say else if. Now why else if? Because if it is not 80, then again a condition is there. So it is greater than 79,999. And basic is less than is equals to how much it is talking about? 60,000. If it is not greater than 80,000, that means it will come below. And where I will calculate? If it is more than 79,999 and it is less than, that means it is between the range of 60,000 and 79,999. So that's why it is included. Now what is the tax percentage? It is 25%. So I will say 0.25. If it is not what it is talking about, let's see. It is saying that between 40 to 59,000. So again I will use else if, but this time 59,000 and this year 40 to 59,000. What is the tax percentage it is talking about? 15%. So I will apply over here 15% of the base. Now what next part it is saying? It is between 20 to 39. That means again I will use else if 39,000. So I will apply 20 to 39,999. What is the percentage? 5%. So this will be your 0.5. Now what is the next part? This is the last part. So I will use else part over here. So that means here I will say this is the last part will be else. Else tax is equal to 0.0. No tax. 0.0. So now tax is calculated. So it is the time to calculate net salary now. So I will say net salary, because look at over here, we have taken the instance variable net, not the net salary. So that's why be careful while writing the instance variables. It is your net. Net is equal to gross minus deduction. What are the deduction we have? Provident fund plus tax. Dono ko milao, mila ke subtraction kar do aap gross. We got the net salary. After this, all the calculation is over. What the question is saying now? It is saying that print slip is a method. Again, we have to define the method. We have to define like this, void print slip. So empty parenthesis, I need to display. So I will say system dot out dot print. What is the first thing that I need to display? Employee code. So I will give a message, employee code delimiter, then plus. What is the instance variable we have taken? EMP code. Let's verify it. Yes, we have taken EMP code. So after displaying employee code, again I will give plus. The mechanism is like this. Message within double quotes, concatenated with instance variable, again concatenated with message. Now here in this message I will put slash in, because I need to display it in the next line. What is the message? Employee name delimiter plus. What is the instance variable name? EMP name. Again plus. What is the next message? Slash in basic salary. It must be in a sequence order. Salary slip. And the instance variable is your basic. Again plus. What is the next thing? All the allowances. I will say HRA. Sir, aapne capital mein le liya. Beta, ye message hai. It can be in capital letter, but instance variable must be in lower case. HRA plus next message is your slash n CCA delimiter plus CCA plus slash n DA for dearness allowance plus instance variable is your DA plus PF provident fund. Then instance variable is your PF. Next is your tax. Instance variable is your tax. After tax, we have to display the slash n gross salary. Instance variable is your gross. Then slash n net salary, which is also known as your take home pay. In some question, you will get take home pay. All the variables I have to display with a sequence. Next is your main method, public static void main. String argument has to be taken. I can take any. Within the main method, my first job is to declare an object of the class. Now, what is the class name? Class name is your employee. So, how to declare an object? Class name, object name is equals to new class name with empty parentheses. After that, I need to call a method. Now, the sequence of calling a method is accept method, then calculation, then display. How to call the method? Object name dot method name. Object name is my EMP dot method name. The method name is your get data. So that's why object name is your EMP dot get data. Next method is your calculation. EMP dot calculate salary. Next method is your display, which is EMP dot print slip. Now let's execute. You will get a little bit problem while doing this. I will say why it is generating a problem and what is the solution. Suppose we have given H001 employee code, then look at this. It is saying employee name and employee basic salary. Employee name is skipped. It is not accepting the data for employee name. Why it is not taking? Let's see. Just check it out over here. When I'm saying next line, it is accepting the data up to new line character. And here, when I'm pressing an enter key, it is taking this new line character over here. This will accept the data up to space or enter key. This will accept the data up to enter key. So I have to give a dummy line over here after this. So execute it. I'm giving H001. Enter key I have pressed. It is ignored now because of this SS.next line. So theory and practical both are different. That's why I'm always saying that learn programming when I'm in front of the system. I can tell you everything. Now suppose I'm saying PRE and the basic salary is your 98,000. Now look at over here. It is displaying the information. Employee code H001. Name is PRE 98,000. Now HRA is your 41,160.61. One space is coming before PF. Let's check why the space is coming. Now we can see that here I have given a space. This space was coming. Now tax, gross salary and net salary. Everything is calculated and displayed. Now let's execute it again. Now I'm giving employee code A008. Now employee name Ramesh Mishra. Now I'm giving 2 votes. No problem. Basic salary. I'm saying 45,000. Now we got the information. HRA, CCA, DA, provident fund, tax, gross salary and the net salary. So hope I'm clear to everyone. Everyone has understood the mechanism of writing the class program. With this, thank you. If you want any other classes like this or constructor, you can write in my comment section. I will create a video and I will send it to you. Thank you.